Hello friends, in this lecture we'll be talking about what supply chain is. We'll be discussing about a basic definition of supply chain, the stages involved in a supply chain, and what are the myths about a supply chain. So let's move on to the next slide. So what is supply chain? In layman terms, supply chain is nothing but a chain of processes or events that happen just to fulfill a customer's need. So from this definition, you just need to look into two things. One is stages and the other is customer's need. So typically a supply chain has five stages, as you must already be aware of. So the first stage is the customer. So first of all, a customer goes to a retailer to purchase a product, and retailer provides a product to the customer. So whenever retailer is in short supply of a particular product, retailer goes to a wholesaler or distributor. A wholesaler or a distributor, they get their products from manufacturers, and manufacturers produce products from raw materials, and raw materials are supplied by suppliers. Let's take the example of Reliance Fresh stores in India. This is the first stage, wherein a customer goes to a retail shop, and here the retail shop or the retailer is nothing but Reliance Fresh store. So this is our stage two. And whenever this Reliance Fresh store is in short supply of products, they are fulfilled by the distribution center. So this is the third stage, which is warehouse or distribution stage. And these distribution centers get the products from the processing unit, which is our fourth stage here, the manufacturing stage. So instead of manufacturing, we have processing unit. This processing unit is getting supplies from these suppliers. First are the raw materials or raw produce from different farmers, and second is the packaging material that is used to packet all the products in standard quantities, and third is chemical manufacturers. So this is our fourth stage, the manufacturing stage, and this is our fifth stage. All the suppliers combined is our fifth stage, right? And there is one more supplier, the supplier of trucks. So Reliance has its own transportation business through which it supplies trucks for any inbound or outbound logistics. So this is also counted in suppliers, right? I think this example explains all the stages involved in a supply chain. What supply chain is not? So there are many myths about supply chain. Let me talk about the most important myths. So first one is, everyone thinks that supply chain is just a movement of a product from one stage to another. I would like to clarify that it is not just the movement of a product. It is also the movement of information and movement of funds, right? This is very important, and as we'll see the flow of all these three, product information and funds, in every example. So here this light green arrows show the direction of flow of product. First, raw materials are supplied by suppliers to manufacturers, then manufacturers supply the material to distributors, and similarly to retailers, and then retailers supply the final product to customers. So this is the flow of product which we are already aware of. So here you can see that, you know, I have drawn all the stages involved in the supply chain. So whenever a customer buys a product from a retailer, he or she pays to the retailer. In the similar fashion, whenever retailers purchase some products from distributors, they pay funds to distributors. And then in a similar way, distributors pay to manufacturers. I think this is very obvious also. So now it is very obvious that flow of product is in this direction as shown here, and the flow of funds is in the opposite direction. So let's talk about the third flow. Third flow is the flow of information, and flow of information has no direction. It is unbiased and it flows in every direction from one point to another, and it will be explained in the next slide through example. Here I'll be talking about the different flows involved across these stages as shown here in this supply chain, right? So here you can see that whenever a customer goes to a Reliance Fresh store to purchase something, as a retailer, Reliance Fresh store provides the customer not just with the product as well as the pricing and availability information. So this Reliance store provides a product, so this is the flow of product in the direction of customer, right? Along with that, you will see that there are many banners that actually show the pricing on each and every product, and there are banners to show the discounts and offers that a Reliance Fresh store is coming up with. So that is the flow of information. So information flow is represented by I, and this was the product flow. Let's denote it with B. And let's say if you want information on a particular product, then you can talk to any of their executives. So for example, let's say if you want a product and you're not able to find it, then that particular executive helps you out. And let's say if a product is not there, then you can get the information of its next availability from the executive. So that's also the inflow of information. Let me denote it with I. So now whenever a customer purchases the product, he or she pays to the Reliance store. So that is flow of funds, right? So now Reliance provides the point of sale data as well as the replenishment orders to the distribution center, right? So here you can see that before retailer gets products from any distributor, so there is a flow of information. So replenishment orders are the orders that a retailer wants a distributor to fulfill that are in short supply in the shop. How do they do it? It is nothing but an Excel file that contains the name of all the products that the retailer is in short supply of, and then the information about how much of each product that the retailer wants. So all the orders are fulfilled by the distribution center. So here you can see this is the flow of information. So now whenever this information goes to a distribution center, then they replenish the order through trucks. So this is the flow of product. So whenever Reliance Fresh Store gets a supply, fresh supply from a distribution center, once they get it, they transfer the funds to the distributor. So this is the flow of funds. Similarly, before the distribution sends an order to Reliance, and they send the information of the delivery schedule and pricing information to the Reliance Fresh Store. So this is the flow of information. On the basis of this information, Reliance makes itself ready to accommodate the supply that is coming in its warehouse as well as in the store itself. And then on the basis of this pricing information, Reliance decides the offers that are to be given to the customers. So yeah, so this is the flow of information. The flow of information is very important, and it is happening more number of times than the flow of funds or flow of product. Flow of product happens once, but flow of information is happening a number of times. I think this will be again explained in the next example. Here, let's say a customer wants to buy an HP laptop from Flipkart. So Flipkart is an online platform wherein a customer goes to its website and places an order for a product. So in this supply chain, you have customers, you have Flipkart's website, which is acting as a retailer, online retailer, and then Flipkart gets its supply from either HP laptop distributor, or it directly gets it from an assembly plant, which was actually the fourth stage manufacturer. So it either gets laptops from the manufacturer itself or from the distributor. So this is the supply chain in this case. So yeah, let's talk about the flow. So here, whenever a customer comes to a Flipkart website, Flipkart provides the customer with the pricing information on the product variety available, and the availability of that particular product. So before any other flow, there is the flow of information again. So this is represented by I. So yeah, after finalizing the product, customer pays for the particular product. So this is the flow of funds in the opposite direction. So after the order is placed, Flipkart provides the order information to different sellers just to check which seller provides the product faster. Then Flipkart engages with the logistics provider. So that is again flow of information. So that is flow of information, right? So after the seller is decided, it provides information to the logistics partner about the order as to from where it is to be picked up and from where it is to, you know, be delivered to. And finally, through the logistics partner, the product is delivered to the customer. So this is the flow of product, right? So at each and every stage, Flipkart also provides order tracking. At each and every stage, it tells the customer which stage the order is in, starting from when Flipkart has fixed the seller, and then to whether it has fixed the logistics partner, and then to whether it has been picked up, or whether it has reached their warehouse, whether it is packed, whether it is again picked up by the logistics partners to deliver to the customer. So that is again flow of information. So now here for order tracking, you can see that each and every stage is providing information to Flipkart, and then Flipkart is providing all the information to the customer. So you can see that flow of information is unbiased to direction. It is flowing from the distributor to finally to the customer. It is flowing from the manufacturer directly to the customer, right? So here I would like to emphasize that the flow of information is more important compared to the flow of product and flow of funds, right? So now the next myth about the supply chain. Some people might think that at each and every stage there is only one player involved. So there is only one supplier who is supplying to one manufacturer, and then the same manufacturer is supplying to only one distributor, and then the same distributor is supplying to only one retailer, and then to customers. So that is not the case. Supply chain is a complex network. There can be many suppliers, many manufacturers, many distributors supplying to each other and cross supplying. For example, a supplier can supply to just one manufacturer, or it can choose to supply to many manufacturers at the same time, or it can even bypass the whole manufacturers and it can directly supply to distributors. And similarly, distributors can directly supply to customers bypassing the retailers. Now the structure of a supply chain depends on what are the customer needs a company wants to fulfill, right? And then on the basis of that, roles of each and every stage is defined. I think it looks easier to talk about it, and let's try and understand it through another example on the next slide. So again, let's talk about Flipkart. So Flipkart has two supply chain structures to fulfill a customer's order. So one is the warehouse stocking model, and then the other one is back-to-back order fulfillment model. So initially when Flipkart started, they were following back-to-back order fulfillment model, wherein they don't store any product from any supplier. They didn't have any warehouse at that time. So in this model, what was happening? So whenever Flipkart gets an order from a customer, so that order information is provided to the logistics, and then logistics pick the product from the vendor, and then that product is brought to their fulfillment center where the product is checked for quality and it is packed properly, and then it is supplied to the customer, right? So now you can see that there are many stages involved in this model. You can see that the logistics partner is being used for two times: one to pick the product from the seller, and then to deliver it to the customer. So now, just to supply the product to the customer in a faster way, Flipkart came up with warehouse stocking model, wherein Flipkart stocks the inventory from various sellers in its warehouse. So whenever Flipkart gets the order from a customer, and if the order is available in their warehouse, so that order is directly supplied from the warehouse. So thereby Flipkart completely bypasses the distributors or the sellers for a particular order, and this makes the whole supply chain faster, and it helps Flipkart to solve or fulfill the customer's need in a better way, right? So here I think this example has made it clear the complex nature of supply chain and how that complex nature is chosen for fulfilling a customer's need, right? Let's just review the whole lecture. We learned in a simple fashion that supply chain is the movement of product, information, and funds across different stages to fulfill a customer's need. Then we explained all the stages involved in the supply chain, and then I think you will have a fair idea of how each and every stage looks like through this example. We emphasize that it is the flow of product information and funds and not just the flow of product only. We could see that in a simple supply chain, there is a flow of information, product and flow, and we could see that flow of information matters more compared to other flows. And then we could see that complex nature of supply chain networks, and the complexity depends upon what customer need you want to solve, right? So this is it for this lecture. So in the next lecture, we'll be talking about the objective of a supply chain. Thank you.